Hey YouTube, this is my first video. I'm kind of actually excited about this. I am starting my very first video on here, and I decided to talk about something that is very, very much so part of me now as an individual. And you know, it is November, so for everyone that doesn't know, November is Diabetes Month, Diabetes Awareness Month, better yet. Just kind of wanted to share my story with the world, and periodically I plan to kind of update new diabetics that might be out there that may, this whole thing may be new to them. You know, I don't know, but somebody somewhere, hopefully that can help. But I've been diagnosed with diabetes since November of 2008. It was actually the day after Thanksgiving. Me and my husband, well, my husband now, we were dating at the time, but we were at a family member's home, and I was just kind of doing what I normally do. Had a couple of margaritas, was kind of craving the whole carb thing. Starchy foods like ham and mashed potatoes, macaroni and cheese, sweet potatoes. Like, I was craving that. Mashed potatoes more so with gravy, might I add. But yeah, so I ate all that stuff, and the next day I kind of woke up, feeling a little like I had a hangover, and I didn't really think anything of it, just thinking I have a hangover. But I was thinking that in past times I've had way more to drink than I did the night before, so that kind of was weird to me a little bit. But I was like, okay, yeah, I just have a hangover. So I laid in bed most of the day. Couldn't really move. Kind of was very weak a little bit. So, yeah, it was a very strange feeling, to say the least. So I attempted to eat something later on that afternoon. Nothing stayed down. Everything came back up. Anything I drank came back up, whether it be water, soda, juice, all that stuff. 7-Up, Sprite, tried it all. And it all came back up. So at that point, you know, I'm like, okay, I'm done with this day. Let me just go to bed and sleep this off. Woke up the next day. Well, really, I didn't even go to sleep that night. I was up all night long, stomach just very queasy, sick, couldn't even sleep. I was just so nauseated to the stomach. It was just like, I mean, it was like my body just could not rest. It was in so much distress and sickness. So woke up, tried to take some Pepto-Bismol. That came back up. Any type of medication that I tried to take came back up. So the next day, my husband said, you think you could be pregnant? So I kind of was like, hell to the no. No way. That's not it. I'm just sick. I don't know what's going on, but that's definitely not it. So he attempted to try and make me some ramen noodles. As soon as the plate got set on my lap, I immediately threw up everywhere. The smell of noodles which is like high in carbs, but the smell of it just made me sick, nauseated again, all up again. So the following day, I was scheduled to return back to work. I couldn't do that. I couldn't take a shower. I couldn't stand for no longer than 10 seconds. I couldn't eat anything. I was constantly thirsty, drinking gallons and gallons and gallons of water a day. And constantly using the restroom. Which, the bathroom part, I was on that prior to me actually getting sick the day after Thanksgiving. I was using the bathroom like crazy and drinking water like crazy. I wanted nothing but water. Nothing would quench my thirst but water. I have to stress that, how thirsty I really was. And it was just running through me, coming right back out. So, next day I was supposed to return back to work. I didn't. Laid on the couch the whole day. My husband had to go back to work, so I'm at home by myself at this point. I was actually having a conversation with a friend on the phone, and I just felt like I could no longer sit there like that anymore. So something said, Keisha, get up. You gotta do something about this. You can't just lay here. So I attempted to go take a shower so I could go to take myself to the emergency room. But the shower thing really didn't work because I couldn't stand, of course. So I was in the shower maybe 1 minute, literally. And I just couldn't stand up any longer. So got out the shower. Tried to attempt to dress myself. And drove myself to the hospital that's probably about 4 minutes away from my home. But I can't really describe the feeling. It was more so like I was dying. As soon as I stepped out, the sun was just overwhelming to my eyes. It was kind of like I was going blind. By the grace of God, something got me to that hospital, because on the way there, I just felt like I could not see. I mean, the sun was literally blinding my eyes. That's how sensitive my eyesight was. I got to the hospital, got out of my car, walked a couple of steps, had to sit in the parking lot, got back up, walked a few more steps, sat in the parking lot, and I got through the emergency room doors and got to the nurse and told her, I need help. I think something's really wrong. I think I'm about to die. I'm very, very sick. They take me to the back. The doctor asked me to pee in a cup. I was so weak to the point where I couldn't even do that. I immediately dropped the cup in the toilet stool. I didn't care at that point. That's how sick and weak I was. I didn't care. So I went back to my hospital bed.